Another way to plot our drawing is to use a layout. Layouts are 2D working environments for creating drawing sheets. Every new AutoCAD drawing has by default two layouts that are shown as tabs next to the Model tab. I can add more layouts by clicking on the plus icon, and I can also rename its layout if I right-click on it and select the Rename option. I will right-click on the Layout 1 and I will select Rename. Then I will type the name A4 size and press Enter. Notice that its name has changed. Similarly, I can delete a layout if I right-click on the layout's name and select the Delete option. In this example, I will delete the third layout I created previously. A warning appears to inform me that the selected layout will be deleted. I will click OK to delete this layout. At this point, I will click on the A4 size layout to open it. As you can see, there is a white area. This area is called paper space, and I can display scaled views of the model space within layout viewports, create tables, schedules, notes, and even insert dimensions for my drawing. As for layout viewports, they are objects that display views of the model space, and as you can see, there is already one in this layout. The first thing I should do is select this viewport by clicking on it and delete it. So I will press the delete button from my keyboard, and once I do, it disappears. Now I need to make the necessary changes in the paper. So I will right-click on the A4 size layout tab, and I will select the Page Setup Manager option. The window Page Setup Manager opens, containing a list with all the existing layouts of the drawing. This window also displays the basic settings of the selected layout. Currently, the A4 size layout is selected, and since I haven't set up the paper yet, most of the setup details are not defined. I will click on Modify to open the Page Setup window. Firstly, from the Printer-Plotter section, I will expand the Name Fields drop-down menu, and I will select the DWG to PDF option. Next, I have to specify the paper size. Since I want to print my drawing in an A4 paper, I will search the option of the paper size list and select the ISO A4 option. I will make sure that from the plot options, the plot object line weight and the plot transparency checkboxes are selected, so the thickness of the lines as well as the transparency will be printed. In case I wished either of these properties to be ignored, I could just unselect the corresponding checkbox. In the next step, I will set the drawing orientation to landscape. Finally, I have to specify the scale of the paper. I will select the millimeters option from the drop-down menu since I'm drawing in the metric system. Now, I have to specify the equivalent of the units I used in the drawing relatively to millimeters. Since I drew in millimeters, one unit will be equal to 1 millimeter. In case I had drawn in centimeters, one unit would be equal to 10 millimeters, since 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. And if I had drawn in meters, one unit would be equal to 1000 millimeters, because 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeters. It's really important to specify the scale of the paper correctly, because the paper is being adjusted according to this scale. So, once I have finished setting up the page, I will click OK to close the Page Setup window. Notice that the basic settings of the selected layout have now changed. At this point, I will also close the Page Setup Manager. I can insert one or multiple viewports in the layout, but before I insert anything, it's really important to check if the insertion scale units that were specified in the model coincide with the ones I specified in the Page Setup window. So, I will open the Format menu and select the Units option. Notice that the insertion scale units are indeed set to millimeters, so I will click OK to close the window and move on to insert a viewport. I can insert a viewport in several ways, however, the simplest one is to click on the rectangular button that can be found in the Layout Viewports panel of the contextual ribbon. Once I click on it, all I have to do is create a rectangular area by specifying two corner points, like I would do if I created a rectangle. So, I will click on the upper left corner and then on the lower right corner of the layout, and notice that the viewport was inserted. Finally, I can set the scale of the viewport by selecting the viewport and expanding the scale list that appears in the status bar. From the available options, I will select the 1 to 100 scale option. As you can see, this scale doesn't have the desired result, so I'm going to change the scale again. If the scale I want to select does not exist among the available options, I can always create it if I click on the Custom option. The Edit Drawing Scales window opens automatically. I will click on the Add button to add a new scale. In the Name field, I will type 1 to 150. And in the Scale properties, I will specify one paper unit to be equivalent to 150 drawing units. Then I will click OK. Notice that this option is already added in the list. I will also close the Edit Drawing Scales window and I will select the viewport again. Now, I will expand the scale list and I will select the 1 to 150 option that I just created. At this point, I will double-click inside the viewport and I will use the Pan tool to move the drawing to the center of the viewport. I should mention that while being inside the viewport, I should be careful not to zoom in or out because the scale will change. I will double-click somewhere on the paper or on the gray area to exit the viewport. Now, I will select the viewport once again and change its layer from the Home ribbon. If we look at the Layers panel, we can see that the viewport was inserted in the Walls layer, which was currently active. I will open the layer list and move it to Layer 1. This is a viewport that cannot be printed since I have deactivated the plotting option. In this way, the frame of the layout won't be printed. Lastly, I should mention that I can add dimensions or text objects in the layout. For instance, if I wish the scale that I have set to the layout to be shown, I can create a text object and write the exact scale that has been used. Once I write the text and close the text editor, notice that the text is too small, so I will double-click on it, select it, and then change its size to 3. Then, I will close the text editor again and click on the grip to move the text in the right position. At this point, I'm ready to print the layout, so I will click on the plot icon from the Quick Access toolbar. Since there are more layout tabs and the model tab, a message appears asking me if I wish to plot multiple sheets. However, I only wish to plot the active layout, so I will select the Continue to plot a sheet option. The settings in the plot window have already been adjusted according to the page setup manager, so all I have to do is click OK. I will save the layout in desktop under the name A4 size. After a few seconds, we can finally see the result.